Greetings, ladies and gentlefish. I bring you this game. This is my first game that I'm showing you from patch 9.2. We are here in the M46 pattern. I'm showing this for a couple of reasons. Firstly, I want to test out the kind of jerky replays I had in patch 9.1 and try and see if I've unjerkified them, de-jerkified them. I don't know what the word would be. So that's the first reason. Secondly, there were a variety of tanks that were buffed in patch 9.2. The only one of those tanks that I owned and was still playing was this thing, the M46 pattern. So I thought, you know, I'd show this game just to see if it's been improved or not. So what they did to this was they improved the accuracy, and I think they improved the accuracy on the move as well. But anyway, we are here on Muravanka with the Magic Forest. And I'm coming over here towards the hills on the right-hand side, and immediately there's a 5916, and immediately he is missing a good chunk of his health, and now he is dead. And I must admit, when you move up the tiers, when you finally get the top gun unlocked on the pattern, it's really nice to be hitting for 390 average damage. The shots feel a lot meatier than they did on the Pershing or on the T20 before. It's really nice. So there's a Waffenträger auf Panzer IV. We put a shot into him and move up. And I'm trying to keep a lot of these bushes between myself and the bad guys in an attempt to not be spotted. Now we try and get some vision through them. I'm just spotting guys at the moment. I don't have a massive desire to shoot things unless something really valuable turns up. Like that Waffenträger. Set him on fire. Ooh, he's sour. And T29 finishes him off. And it doesn't look like I actually got spotted for that, which is quite nice. But I'm still rather paranoid about such things. Down there is a T-34. There's also an E-75 that we saw drive down there earlier on, so I want to be a little bit careful. But conversely, I'm slightly disconcerted by the number of our team that are bunched up here, and the enemy does have three artillery pieces. So we do need to be a little bit careful. Our artillery nukes that T-34 into oblivion, T-69 in the background, but our tanks appear to be going balls deep with these guys and really going for it, so screw it, I'm going to back them up and help them. Track the E-75 there. You could argue that was a little bit unlucky, but hopefully I'll get some assistance damage out of it. E-50 is on low health, aim my shot, and put the E-50 out of his misery. And now this E-75 is really wishing that he had some friends, but he doesn't. Sucks to be him. And there we go, he's got no health left, he is dead. And basically this is a wolf pack of medium and heavy tanks, and there I take an artillery shot to the side. I don't think it was a direct hit because I only took 400 odd damage. I'd have expected to have taken more if it had been a direct hit, but it does kill my gunner, so I put him back in using the defibrillator that we keep on hand in this tank. Ah, oh, medkits, never change. So we keep moving along this ridgeline. Just seeing what we can see. They've basically got tanks at the bottom. There'll be things like artillery and over in the wood. And on the ridge behind the wood at sort of H9. So there goes one of their artillery pieces. And there's a tank destroyer who's been lit up. And let's see if we can get any shots on him. There he is, Ferdinand. Sweet, sweet Ferdinand. There he is. Ooh, one shot into the side. That one looks like it stung. T-34 polishes him off. And the scoreline is 8-2. This is looking like it's going to be a pretty nice win. They've got one artillery piece left. He's probably hiding at the back there somewhere, waiting to shotgun the first person to drive around the corner of a building. There he is. See? Right at the back. But doesn't do him any good. He dies. 9-2. Screw capping. I have no interest in capping whatsoever. I want to do more damage, kill more things, and get some more experience and credits. And there's a KV-1. What's a KV-1S doing in this game? Did he platoon up with someone stupid? He must have done. Oh well. I'm not even bothering. I just want to get closer because this gun is really not a sniper rifle. Ooh, shot on the T69 though. Nice clean shot. This gun does not like to be used at range, although I've been having success with it at range in this game. It's much more of a close range weapon. Its accuracy, despite the fact that it's been buffed, is not what you would call good. There's five of them left. Ooh, Leopard prototype. There we go. Nice meaty shot into his side. And we just keep moving up. AMX 5120. Ooh, so many targets. Right, let's try and do something about some of these. There's four of them left, and there they all are. Fire at the prototype on the move. Somehow bounce on him. I mean, his armor's garbage, but whatever. See if we can finish off the KV-1S, but someone else beats me to it. That shot goes through the Leopard. I take a shot in the side from their SU-152, but he pays for it with his life as the Centurion wrecks him. Leopard prototype is on 50-odd health. We're capping. I'm sure we'll be able to kill these guys anyway. I'm not really worried about the cap. Finish off the AMX-5120. They finish the cap, and we kill the Leopard prototype. And that was the game. Pretty nice game. You know, wasn't particularly challenging, but this tank is growing on me, I must admit, with time. Before you have the top gun unlocked, it is frustrating as all hell, but the top gun and the top engine really do make it a much nicer tank to play. With its really nice DPM. So that game was a second class mastery, Confederate, tank sniper. I know I said the gun wasn't a sniper rifle, but there we go. Top XP on the team. So it was a pretty good game. It was good fun to play. So hopefully that's given you a bit of a taste of what the M46 pattern is like for any of you who are interested in going down the American medium line. And hopefully that replay comes across without too much in the way of jerkiness going on. That would be nice. Either way, I hope you guys enjoyed that. If you did, please feel free to catch some of my other videos and or subscribe to my channel. And I wish you very happy hunting on that battlefield. Ciao, ciao.